We communicate with words. When you talk to me, I understand what you mean. But computers can't do that naturally. They operate with numbers. If we want machines to understand what we're saying, we need to help them out. We need a way to convert text into something numerical. Well, I've got a bag of words right here that'll do the trick. Bag of words sounds made up, but it's actually a pretty powerful model that will get us started in natural language processing. Today, we're going to explore how this model works, its strengths, its limitations, and how it paves the way for more complex language processing techniques. Behold, a piece of text. With the bag of words model, we toss these words into a bag. Shaking is optional. The original structure, grammar, and word order are all lost in the mix. What remains are just the individual words. This process transforms qualitative data, the text, into quantitative data, the numbers. Each word in the bag is then counted, creating a collection of words along with their frequencies. If you're someone who labors over every word you write, this might seem a bit horrifying. But in machine learning, word frequency alone often provides enough information to draw meaningful conclusions. By the way, if you're looking for more of this kind of next-level lesson that incorporates math, computer programming, obscure music references, you can sign up for courses at socratica.com, where you can hashtag learn more. Now, back to this bag of words. In natural language processing, any text from an email to a web page is called a document, or doc for short. The process of extracting data from these docs is known as feature extraction. Using this terminology, the bag of words model can be described as a method of feature extraction from docs, where the words and their frequencies are the features. Let's create a bag of words using an excerpt from The Foundation by Isaac Asimov. He had steeled himself just a little for the jump through hyperspace, a phenomenon one did not experience in simple interplanetary trips. The jump remained, and would probably remain forever, the only practical method of traveling between the stars. Travel through ordinary space could proceed at no rate more rapid than that of ordinary light, a bit of scientific knowledge that belonged among the items known since the forgotten dawn of human history. And that would have meant years of travel between even the nearest of inhabited systems, through hyperspace, that unimaginable region that was neither space nor time, matter nor energy, something nor nothing. One could traverse the length of the galaxy in the interval between two neighboring instants of time. We'll start exploring this text using the Wolfram language, known for its readability, especially for those who aren't programmers. Shortly after, we'll demonstrate how to store a bag of words using Python, the most popular language in AI research. There are 122 words in this text sample. Next, we can look at each word along with the number of times it is used. We will ignore case when counting the words. The word the is used 10 times, of occurs 8 times, and so on. As you can see, most words were only used once. This is common with skilled authors who have a large vocabulary. And if we look at the number of entries in our bag of words, there are only 83 distinct words. So, there are 39 words that are repeats. A bag of words is a specific application of a more general idea that's studied in mathematics, specifically discrete math and combinatorics. In math, a set is a collection of unique items. Since a bag of words can have repeated words, it's not a set. However, it is an example of a multiset. A multiset is a collection of items where repeats are permitted. Tuck this away in your brain, because if you ever run into a puzzle when working with bags of words, there's a good chance that mathematicians have already solved it. But you'll need to know these math terms when cracking open that math book. A bag of words is a good first step in extracting features from a piece of text, but it's not the only step. There are still words, and as we've mentioned before, computers prefer numbers. So in the next step, we're going to convert each bag of words into a vector. Let's see how this is done. Imagine if you took all the words in the English language and then sorted them by how frequently they were used. For a visual, here are the first 100 words, but imagine this list going on and on. To demonstrate the word removing technique, let's load the text for the book The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. This book has 104,666 words. First, let's construct the bag of words by counting how often each word appears. When we're doing this, we'll ignore letter case. For the next step, we'll take the list of the 100 most commonly used words and replace each word with how often it occurs in the book. If we look up how many times the appears, we get 5,627. The next word, be, occurs 627 times. To is used 2,684 times, and so on. If you do this for all the words, you get a sequence of numbers. Here, we're only showing the first 100 numbers, but you could compute this for the entire English dictionary. This sequence of numbers is a vector, and it lives in vector space. The length of the vector is the dimension of the vector space. This shortened example is a vector in 100-dimensional space, but in practice, you would use many more words, which means a much higher dimension. In natural language processing, you will often refer to this vector space as feature space, since the numbers and vectors are features extracted from text. Let's look at the feature vector for a much longer book, War and Peace. As you can see, each number in this vector is many times larger than for Sherlock Holmes. This can complicate things because larger documents inherently have higher word counts. To address this, a simple yet effective approach is to divide each number in the feature vector by the total number of words in the document. This technique, called normalization, adjusts for the document length and allows for more meaningful comparisons between docs of different sizes. We have seen how you can take a doc, convert it to a bag of words, then turn this into a vector inside feature space. Normalization is a helpful step before you start training your machine learning algorithms. In upcoming lessons, we'll learn about similar techniques like TF-IDF, which stands for Term Frequency Inverse Doc Frequency. So be sure to put Socratica into your bag of subscribed channels.